Vocabulary is undoubtedly one of the hardest things to learn in a foreign language. And people often wonder what is the best method to learn vocabulary, how you can learn vocabulary effectively. And they assume that this process is tedious, hard, and boring because, well, they make it tedious, hard, and boring. One of the most popular ways to learn foreign language vocabulary is SRS, and that's short for spaced repetition systems. Things like Anki, Memrise, and other softwares, apps you might have seen around. And you sure know them because tons and tons of bloggers, YouTubers recommend them for vocabulary. A lot of these people seem to glorify SRS for their effectiveness. But what they don't talk about is what I call the dark side of SRS and flashcards in general. You see, I'm gonna argue that flashcards and SRS in general are not only an inefficient way to learn vocabulary, but they can also be harmful for your studies. I know that this is gonna be a pretty controversial video because apparently a lot of people and polyglots themselves swear by flashcards, but you know, I was one of those people as well in the past, but now I actually think I was wrong. So in this video, I'm gonna address how people usually use SRS to learn vocabulary and why I think this is wrong. I tell you, this is gonna be a long video, so grab your coffee, I got my tea here, or your beverage of choice, I'm not gonna judge, and let's jump right in. Now, there are three kinds of people when it comes to SRS learning. The first one is what I call the lazy ones, is just people who massively download decks for Anki, Memrise, and Quizlet, and what have you. I was one of those people, yeah. Then there's the people I call the crafters, which are the guys who make each flashcard for every word they encounter in a foreign language, and their flashcards usually contain video, audio, hints, examples, sentences, pictures, whatever. And lastly, there's the people who get their vocabulary from either frequency lists or the vocabulary section of their textbooks, and they just copy the word and its translation into their flashcards. Then what do these people do next? They start endlessly drilling those words into their brains, which is fine if you have a few hundred words, but then when the vocabulary starts accumulating, SRS review will take up pretty much all of the study time. And this is wrong. You need to stop it. This is not the way to learn vocabulary. Just endless flashcard drilling is not the optimal way, in my opinion. And I'll give you some reasons why. First of all, making flashcards is time consuming. Believe it or not, crafting flashcards with all kinds of pictures is time consuming. You see, most people just don't have enough time to dedicate for that. And if you're like me and you have a job, then the majority of people will allocate maybe an hour a day or 30 minutes a day for language learning, and this is not time to dedicate to arts and crafts. And I tell you this because it is exactly what I used to do when I started Korean some years ago, and following the directions of the book Fluent Forever, I used to make myself flashcards with all kinds of stuff in it. I used to download audio and draw pictures and make mnemonics and all that kind of stuff, and that would take hours, if not days, of my time to learn like 100 words. That's not good. When native people speak, they use thousands of words, and you can guess how long it would have taken me to actually become fluent in Korean by following this method. And funnily enough, at that time I actually thought I was a super efficient language learner. Now I know that at this point a lot of people are gonna be coming at me telling me that, oh, but making flashcards is learning vocabulary in itself, To which my answer is a resounding no. It's not. Engaging with words in context is learning vocabulary. Drawing pictures on flashcards just isn't. Now, another reason why flashcards are just not good for language learning and vocabulary in particular is because of the way they are designed. Flashcards encourage you to go for one-on-one translation, that is, word and its translation, and it's one word, one translation. And this is just not the way languages work. Now, this creates two major problems. The first one is that, of course, there is no language that translates itself perfectly into another language, because each language has a different way to express situations and things in general. The second one is that, of course, in a language, words have more than one meaning, and learning each word with just one meaning at a time not only slows you down terribly, but it limits your knowledge of vocabulary. And this brings me to another disadvantage of flashcards in general, which is lack of context. You see, this is the thing with words, is that words are like people. And what I mean by that is, in the case of people, you never truly know a person's character until you've seen that person behave in different kinds of contexts, like at work, with family, with friends, in official situations, etc. I believe you all know this feeling. You think you know someone, and then you see a completely different side of that person that shocks you, but at the same time helps you understand that person better. Well, the same applies with words. You never truly know a word until you've experienced it in multiple contexts. Therefore, with flashcards, limiting the meaning of a word into only one translation, one context, and drilling it into our brain until it becomes second nature limits our view of the language, thus making us ignorant. Yes, flashcards make us ignorant. Another aspect that I don't agree with the language learning community and SRS learning in general is that there is too much focus on memorizing words instead of understanding, instead of learning them, actually. And this is a mistake a lot of people make, and I've seen it throughout the web and YouTube and stuff, is that people mistake memorizing with knowledge. Memorizing is knowing what's on the back of a card, which is fine, but you can't say that you know that word. You've memorized it, of course, but you don't really know it. You don't really understand it because you're focused just on memorizing it. So let me break it down to you. SRS is spaced repetition. It is not spaced learning. That is, SRS is a way to review stuff, not actually learn it. There's one thing that is always overlooked, at least in my opinion, with vocabulary learning, which is far more important than memorizing, and that is building associations with words, linking words to their context, building these neural paths, these connections in our brain. And you can do this, of course, with context, but also with the things that you're listening to, that you're watching, that you're reading in a foreign language. You see, if your goal in a foreign language is to communicate, is to understand that foreign language, then it makes no sense to focus on memorization. Instead, we should focus on what helps us really understand and communicate, which again is lots of reading, lots of listening, and ultimately speaking in the foreign language. You see, I'm gonna argue that SRS is kind of like trying to force feed our brain into learning and memorizing things that it's not just ready for, or it's not even interested in. On the other hand, engaging in compelling activities will kind of seduce our brain into learning while actually not making it look like learning. So you're understanding words while having fun, and that is the greatest thing ever. In my opinion, learning should be memorable. We need to make learning memorable. And context, not just context, but compelling context, makes learning more memorable. And when learning is memorable, that is, when we create memories because we're having so much fun engaging with the language, this will make words harder to forget. For example, there is a word in Korean which I'll never be able to forget. It's just stamped into my brain. And that word is traitor. Traitor in Korean is 배신자. And this was one of the first words I learned in Korean, and this is because I'm a huge fanatic of Korean variety shows. And that is a word that comes up super often because people are constantly betraying each other in their little games that they play. And this is, to me, it's fun. And that was one of the words, the first words that I've learned in Korean. And this was so memorable. It was so much fun that to me, 배신자 will always be on my brain. Moreover, using flashcards on a daily basis can actually cause stress and motivation loss. This is because, believe it or not, being tested on a daily basis, whether or not you know a word, can cause stress for a lot of people. It can be stressful, at least for me it is. And stress is one of the factors that contribute in killing motivations and making people give up on language learning. I don't know about you, but for me, being tested every day takes the fun out of language learning. And this is sad because getting things wrong on a daily basis can induce negativity, and it's super dangerous when we start to associate language learning and language learning routines with negativity. That is just a very dangerous path to go in because it makes you super easy to give up. But on the other hand, always getting things right, that is always pushing that easy button on Anki, can give you a false sense of confidence. It creates the illusion that you know the word, but as we've discussed before, you don't really know the word. You have memorized what's on the back of that card. And finally, as you might have guessed, flashcard drilling is just plain boring. And this, of course, is personal because there might be people who enjoy drilling themselves with flashcards on a daily basis. But for me, the sole thinking of just sitting through an SRS session makes me want to kill myself. Well, maybe not kill myself, but it's boring, guys, really. So, at the end of the day, are flashcards really all that bad for language learning? Now, flashcards aren't bad per se, because they can be super useful for learning simple facts or math formulas, but this is the thing. Language learning is not like learning maths or learning capitals of countries or learning flags and stuff like that. Language learning is a totally different kind of subject that needs its own methods. And this is a mistake that a lot of people make, I've seen. People think that if something works for a subject, then it will work well for language learning as well. But there might be an area of language learning where flashcards are actually useful, and that is tests. And what I mean by tests is like proficiency tests or exams that people take at university. The difference here is that the goal of learning is different. You see, when you're learning a language in order to pass an exam, then flashcards cramming can be actually pretty useful. This is because the questions in a language exams, like the ones you take at university, are usually taken out of context. And I remember back in the day when I was at university and I was taking Japanese, I had kanji exams. And in these kinds of exams, they would give me the pronunciation of a kanji character, and I would need to write the kanji. And flashcards helped me immensely in that. And this is because it was a one-on-one situation out of context. Same things for proficiency tests. Flashcards can be super useful for taking these kinds of tests because the amount of vocabulary used is usually a lot smaller than a native conversation. So proficiency tests usually have a few hundred words that you need to memorize, and usually these words are used in just one context or maximum like two or three different types of contests. So flashcards are super useful for that. But SRS stops making sense when you're learning a language to achieve fluency. This is because you're not learning a language to pass a test, you're learning it to understand the language, to speak, to talk about stuff in that language. I remember when I finished university and I started doing self-study, in my case with Korean again, I wanted to use flashcards because I remember that they worked for my past university experience, and I felt like these flashcards were starting to become more like work, more like chores, than actually enjoying the language. And this is because, again, my goal was different. My goal changed from passing an exam to speak a language. So at the end of the day, here's my point. You're gonna remember words anyway, even without an SRS that helps you out. While on the other hand, using SRS alone will never help you to understand how words work in a language. So that's it for this video. Let me know in the comments if you've ever used flashcards, if you like using flashcards, because I know that there are strange people out there who actually love them. And let me know if I made you change your mind about SRS in general. Next week, I'll talk about how I actually learn vocabulary, the methods that I use. So let me know if you'd like to see my next video by liking this one and clicking on the subscribe button. See you next week.